beast is dead. In the village, the grateful townsfolk gather. A celebration is planned. The heroes are invited to the inn for a night of song and good company. Later that evening,
hi, folks, and welcome to Let's Play Menzoberranzan. It has been a bit. This is actually one of the earlier Let's Plays on my channel. I want to say I played it within my first year or two. The Let's Play, the original Let's Play, is as of this moment 11 years old, and you know I've come a little ways since then. And I believe that was also the 1.0 version of the game, and we're going to be playing 1.1 here. I don't recall whether or not I ever patched in that playthrough. Suffice it to say, YouTube is different, times have changed, audio quality is better, no more obnoxious intros, and I've been wanting to go back to some old DOS games. So I'm probably going to play through this trilogy again. Menzoberranzan is my favorite of them, but I don't think it's the best. I think Stone Prophet is probably the best of them. But we're just going to go ahead and jump right in here.
Lol, hear me. Our enemies hide among the shadows. They move in ways we cannot understand. My queen, have we displeased you? I am here. Matron Malice has set fate in motion. Her warriors seek out Drift, Duerden's traitorous son. In this, she does more than she knows. A fateful hour approaches. Drift shall return, and with him intruders from the world above. These surface... My queen, I hear and I obey. Now, come to me, my servant. Approach and begin the search. Reveal for my eyes these surface dwellers. One by one, reveal the sex, race, and class of these unwelcome visitors. In this way, we might best prepare. Reveal the sex of the first character.
I always thought the character generation in these games was pretty nifty. Like, it's a total gimmick, but back in the day, this was, like, mind-blowing. Like, the fucking intro movie, like, I think that's a Remoraz that they're fighting, and it just looks like a tube with spikes coming out of it. It's terrible. But I have to say, this is, like, in the era of, like, the pixel art. The pixel art in this game is choice. Like, probably the... SSI knew what they were doing when it came to development. I think this was actually developed by DreamForge, maybe? I would have to look. Suffice it to say, pixel art's gorgeous. This is kind of at like the tail end as games were transitioning into 3D graphics, as you can see here, before like 3D had taken over completely. So we got some pretty shit to look at coming up after this. Okay, so in my original playthrough of this, I ran as Swellen Goldleaf, so a paladin and a cleric. I'm not going to do the same thing here, because that's just too, like, on the nose, I think. You know, why do the exact same thing? So we're going to do Chunk and Rove, which is going to be really, really rough, I think. I don't know if they actually let you do evil characters in this. We might have to make Rove like chaotic neutral or something. We'll see.
Show the class of the first character.
All right, so in AD&D, this is, I think, based off of like a mashup of first and second edition. Chunk is a fighter thief, which I think you can multi, you should be able to multi-class like that. Let's find out what happens. I'm gonna do thief first, just in case we're stuck with it. Okay, yeah, there we go. Fighter thief.
Reveal the alignment of the first character.
This is gonna be a fucking party of cutthroats. Cause Chunk is lawful neutral. Oh, it's not gonna let him be, it's not gonna let him be lawful, or is it cause he's good? It doesn't look like we're gonna be able to be evil. Can he not be lawful? Oh no, there we go. Lawful neutral.
Make
weird. Can't be lawful good. Probably because he's a thief, if I had to guess. Okay. Let's see what kind of portraits we have here. The last time I played this was when I did my playthrough, so do we have multiple pages? I don't recall. Oh yeah, we have a more button. Okay. That's pretty Chunk, but Chunk ain't that old. Since this is AD&D rules, this is younger Chunk. As the additions march on. Hey, it's Swell! I love it. OG Swell. I guess we'll go with this guy. Why not? Like, look at this! This shit was mind-blowing in the early 90s. You're like, that rock just exploded! There's a spider! There are dice! Mother of God! Oh, that's right, these games have, like, totally imba stat rolls, that's right. Give me better. I need, like 3d6 down the line, my ass. I think you can move stats around. Oh, and you can also change them, that's wonderful. No, we're gonna roll 1864, that percentile strength. But the Dex and Connor are rough. I want an 18 strength because he gets percent. Fuck you, game. Because he gets percentiles. And I would like at least a 16 in Dex and Con. 1880. The game is fucking with me, man. I'm just waiting for it to throw an 18-100. 1805 ain't great. 24. Come on. I probably should have taken that 1880 if I had to guess. Okay, maybe we'll roll until I have a percentile strength that's good, and then I'll move stats around if we have good stats. Just to save the constant thrumming, because it's going to give me a headache. You can give me another 18 at any time now, game. 1883, all right. And we'll give him a 17 con, 12 wisdom. Yeah, sure, why not? Yeah.
Reveal the name of the first keep.
All right.
Or delete the-
just totally destroying my immersion. Keep or delete? You delete. How do you delete a pert well? Never mind.
Reveal.
All right, we've already heard you barking once, lady. Let's get our stuff done here. I think this is probably my favorite animation of all of them. The candle burning down into layers.
Make known the race of the second character.
All right. Elf. He's gonna suck and have a really... oh god, he's gonna have like a hit point. Oh no. We don't get to see our hit points though, so I can't reroll until he's got dumpster stats. Also, I think we start higher than first level, so...
show the class of the second character.
Our lad is just a wizard. Or a mage. And then I think you just hit select. There we go.
Reveal the alignment. the second character.
All right, game. Do I get evil? I do not. That is wholly disappointing, but chaotic neutral will have to serve. I'd love to say that this is before, like, Rove was a power-hungry, world-destroying psychopath. But I think we all know that's a lie. He was born that way. Alright, let's find a Rove face. Sadly, there are no elves with blue skin. There actually really aren't that many elves. There are, like, no elves. I mean, we've got, like, this one. That is, like, not a Rove. Rove has white hair, so we'll go with this one. That's as close as we're gonna get. Canonically, Rove is Rove from Might and Magic 4 and 5, so he's got blue skin and white hair. We don't talk about it. He's very sensitive about the subject. Alright, let's roll until we get that 18 intelligence. Or I suppose we can just move things around as we deem fit. Good God, 3 18s! Good Lord. I mean, we have to dumpster his constitution. Yeah, okay.
Reveal the name of the.
How many letters do I have here? Not as many as I'd like. All right. One day.
Keep or delete the.
It's a very white drow,
and
by the way.
The mold is set. Let the adventure begin.
Pretty sure dark elves have, like, onyx skin, like jet black, you know? That's their whole thing. Oh, that's right, and these games have, like, the super flowery language that I have issues reading. Oh, God. See, the hardest part of this for me is I know what swell sounds like in my head, and I know what gold leaf sounds like in my head, but by and large, Chunk and Rove don't really talk too much, which is funny because I played the entirety of Boulder's Gate with Chunk leading the party. But I think Rove would probably have, like, kind of like a. I would describe his manner of speech as snake-like, not like in that he, like, rolls his S's or whatever, stresses the S's, sibilance, but that he's just, like, he sounds scummy. Why has the music stopped? Have the flutes faded off into the night and the dancers and the joyous voices with them? Is not our victory worth a night-long celebration? We should demand an explanation from the innkeeper. All right, but first, hear me out. I'm gonna save. They do give you a quick start party, which is actually not horrible, but you probably want to do your own thing. And I mean, like, realistically, you really want a cleric. Because, like, off the top of my head, I don't know if there's, like, another cleric you can pick up in this. I'll have to go look in, or we'll just play and depend on potions. Alright, Rove, what you got, buddy? I'm gonna take 2 Agonizers, Fireball. Alright, this is very, very appropriate, Rove. Don't need armor, I'm gonna give you 2 magic missiles. Light is situationally very useful in this. Alright. And I think we can rest, but I'm not going to, so he should have spells. Yup, he can detect secret doors because he's an elf, and Chunk can backstab, detect noise, hide in shadows, etc. But actually, no, I don't know how, like, backstab and stuff works. Chunk casts backstab. Explain. All right, this is a game that I sadly do not have in box form. I wish I did, but box copies of this game, like, pretty regularly retail for in the like range of $75 to $150, and no? Okay, so we have a couple extra spells for him. It's like that with all of these. Curse of Strahd, or Strahd's Revenge, whichever, the Ravenloft one, and the Ravenloft, what's it? Stone Prophet is the same way. All right, we're stuck in chunky movement. I know there's a way to disable this, but I want to find out how. Step movement off. Palette intensity. Okay, so that's just brightness. We're okay. All right, I think I'm pretty comfortable with everything. So now we should have smooth Well, I throw smooth in air quotes because this is an old DOS game. But, like, it's nice looking. Like, it doesn't look bad at all. The sprite work's all really good. The paper dowels are nice. There's occasional voice acting that's mostly bad, but occasionally, eh. Like this. Innkeeper, the timbers of this place grew still. The rafters above us wait silent as the roof of a forest before a storm. I've watched your customers slip away one by one. Where have they gone?
Ah, my friend. You met the danger well today. The townsfolk owe you much, as do I. It is some strange stillness has drawn them from us this evening. I cannot account for it, but I feel it as keenly as they do. Yes, the beast is dead, but I fear another evil is about the land. Perhaps it's best if you too find a locked door and safe bed for the night. Listen! Fire, they are shouting! And a fire it must be! Quickly, there are buckets outside the door, filled with water for the kitchen. Take them and end that unwelcome light. Your day's work is not yet done. But remember, return before this night is over, for I have not yet given you my reward.
Yeah, he gives us a thing that I'm probably going to not be taking with us. Alright, I'm gonna save again. There may be a quick save button. I honestly don't recall. We do have the glory of an auto map. The auto map in this game is actually really good. You can do notes and all that fun stuff. All right, so we're in town. You can see it's very dark, but light makes it a little bit less dark, at least in our immediate area. Oh God, Chunk. Chunk just probably sounds, I don't know that Chunk necessarily needs a voice because he would be a smoothly spoken dwarf. I shouldn't say smoothly, like a soft spoken dwarf. There's a well to the east near the center of town. We'll find empty buckets near it and we can fill them at the well. All right, I have to remember. I think there's a way, there we go. Double right click to throw things into your inventory. But there are drow about, and since we have a magic user in the party, he's going to be more or less completely useless against them. Because this is back in the days of yore, where spell resistance on enemies was like a percentile value, and dark elves had like an 80% spell resistance or something. So, I mean, we can't go into this one. There are houses in this town that we can go into. Like, you can see that there's this little dot over here, and the map key tells us it's an object. I miss games with mini-maps like this. I get that it doesn't really work for games anymore because of how advanced they are geometrically by comparison to this, because, I mean, this is just like a flat plane, right? Added armor. Same as leather, but it weighs less, so we're going to hold on to that. We'll just ditch the leather. I know there's crap all over the place in this town. There's also a barracks we can bust into. There's a fighter that I can get in my party. I believe he's like, oh shit, it's a drow. Chunk just hit for a 16. Holy damn, bro. Oh, and I think this game actually has lighting at night. So if I like, yeah, it's hard to see because the spell effects flip by so fast. But like, while he torched that dude, like the buildings lit up and stuff. Heat fart cloud. I don't know if it got him or not. Did it get him? Is he stunned? Oh, he's totally stunned. Get fucked, buddy. Row of swings and misses. Come on, guys. He's like stunned. Thank you. I'm actually surprised that worked. Normally, I stick to stuff like Agonaz or Scorcher in this. We don't have it yet. Burning Hands is really good. Stuff like Stinking Cloud is too, I would almost say like too permanent. And by that, I mean most combat in this game flips by really damn quick. So it's not necessarily worth going too crazy about stuff. All right, spear 1-6, 1-8, 1-8, 1-8. So you'll know that weapons have two damage values. The value on the left is a damage against human size and smaller enemies. And the damage on the right is against larger than man size enemies. So like a spear does a D6 against a human. But if I were attacking like an ogre, or in this case, it would be a Verbeeg giant. It would do a little bit more damage. And you can lob spears if you really want to. Oh, that's why he did so much damage on that first swing. I think he backstabbed that drow. All right, let's find out. Let's do some science. Yeah! Oh, and he can just toggle it on. Okay, thieves? No. Not, do it again. Okay, thieves may be pretty good. This seems like broken as shit. I love it. Fucking love it. Oh, hey, friendo. And he just, Rove just gained a level. Hell yeah. Oh, I'm excited. I am so excited to play this. I fucking love this game so much. Everybody's like, it's got Drist in it. Yeah, but you lose him at like an hour after you get him. And then you get to like the more interesting characters. I know that that asshole is around here somewhere. Hiding at the side of a building. I just wish the game didn't pause when you cast spells. That makes it kind of rough. Oh shit, it survived. Oh shit, it survived. Ooh, that's a lot of drow. Uh-oh. Gotta keep them all in front of us. That's a... Alright, Rove, cast armor. On yourself, please. We have another one, like, to our side or something? No. He's not poisoned. No, he's fine. He's just being terrible. But yeah, Rove does not have the hit points. He took a hit, which, I mean, in Rove's case is impressive. This game also has some stuff that we'll have to deal with later with regards to party formation and how you fight. Right now, it's not an issue because we're fighting outdoors. So no matter where they are in our party, people can attack. But like, for example, in a dungeon, if we had a fighter in Rove's position and then Rove were in back, he probably wouldn't be able to attack with a quarterstaff. He would need like either a ranged weapon or maybe a polearm. I don't recall whether or not you can get away with polearms in this one or not. This is the last one, though, so if you can get away with them in any of them, it would be in this one. Just look at all these drow just running around, man. Rove, actually, you gained a level. What level are you? He's level 6. And Chunk is 5 and 6. All right. Nowhere near leveling in anything. But that does mean that Rove's going to have more spells per day. Another fireball and an additional magic missile. Which I actually think for the time being, I'm going to give him an armor spell just to keep him alive. Okay, but seriously though, I have, oh, he's right down here. Okay, I've been like walking past shit. More water. Yeah, I think this is the barracks. There's the town hall that's on fire. He should be right here. Yes.
Is it you, my friend? Take care, the shadows are alive with dark elves.
Oh god, the writing in this is so fucking flowery.
Balthasar, I sense a dark magic as though it has risen up from the bowels of the earth. But evil is upon us this night. Where are your men?
Our enemy has come out of the night. My men are doing what they can, but I have no one to battle the fire. Go, my friend. There are buckets before the tavern. I must stay here. If the drow capture the guardhouse, all is lost.
Okay. And we'll just leave. If you right-click, you just drop out. Once we fight off the drow and we put the fire out here, then we can have him join our party. I don't believe he'll follow us into the Underdark, though. Because eventually we go into the Underdark, and there are a handful of NPCs that just are not okay with that. This game, I think this game has probably the weakest of the hirelings with regards to them being interesting. They're never going to be Stone Prophet. I think of the three, Stone Prophet has by far the best hirelings. You can have a fucking troll and a Wemmick in your party. So good. Never enough. Not to mention, like, I think there's like an undead paladin in there too, which is just the most badass thing. Okay, so I think the bow is probably all we really want in here. I could have sworn. That's just this stuff being weird and how it's stacking. I thought that there was actually like, yeah, it's just stuff stacking weird. Damn it. There was like a wand or something in here. Is there something? Yeah, disappointment. All right, I mean, we got a bow, which theoretically I think Rove should be able to use. Yeah. 8 arrows. I know you can put this quiver on. There we go. The problem with him using a bow, though, is then that I'm going to have to go fishing the arrows out. It's why I'm not using, like, throwing weapons. Actually, see, AC 0, does armor stack with braces of protection? It does. These are How the fuck would that work? That's not how that should work. I'm okay with it, but it's not how it should work. Ah, we shouldn't rest before the fire's out. Damn it, Rove, that's awfully good aligned of you. I'm very disappointed. All right, let's, yeah, the innkeeper had some bauble he wants to give us. Pro tip, you don't want the bauble. You may think you do, but you don't want the bauble. All right, let's remember how to do this. I love that splashy splash. Wow, that's some range, Rove. Holy damn, man, you took out like half a building with one bucket. Okay, all right. I have to go back and find the fucking well, which I think is actually right there. I mean, there's, like I said, there's crap laying all over the place, and it looks like the sun's actually rising too. There's something, oh, see, like, you can tell it's the Forgotten Realms because you're just walking around in town. We actually don't need that. You're just walking around in town and there are just magic user scrolls laying around. That's how you know. Elminster is probably like in the loo or something. Yes, there's a fire, we know. Storehouse is still on fire, you guys. I don't know if you know this, but the town literally on fire right now. Let's try and aim for maximum saturation here. All right, one more trip should do it. And the sun is rising. Day and night cycles, it's amazing. New tech. Fucking love it. I love this game so much, oh my god. I'm so excited to play this. I adore this game. It's like I said, it's not the best of the trilogy. The fire's out. Now we must find the captain of the guard. Baldassar will need our help. Know I anything of that loyal man? Tis this. Alive or dead, he'll be at his post at the guardhouse. To the guardhouse. Alright, now let's do this. I don't remember if there's really not a quick way to drop things, sadly. That's okay. We just have our piles of garbage. Do that. I don't know why I'm holding onto this dagger. Potion of Giant Strength, tentatively useful. All right, Baldassar, join my party. I need you to help me kick the shit out of some gnolls.
The fire, is that under control? How terrible, Drow raiders. Driss has walked among us for so long, I had forgotten the evil of the rest.
The fire's out, Baldassar. Now, let us rout these dark intruders, and if Driss has arranged this evil night, let us end his days about Icewind Dale forever. Chunk, you're fifth level, bro. A for effort, but execution's gonna get you dead.
Yes, this was a Drow raid, but I cannot believe Drist has done us harm. No, not that one, not him.
Let's see. The fire is out, Baldassar, but I feel as though my pockets have been picked while my attention was elsewhere. What have the raiders taken?
Many of our friends have been taken away to be hostages, slaves. The Drow moved quickly. My men are scattered, confused. Terrible.
Voice acting.
We must get after them. Oh, you must be exhausted. Will you join us?
Aye. There's no use defending the guardhouse now. I will join you. But be not hasty, my friend. There are many good weapons within. We should arm ourselves, then pursue the Drow.
Dude, we've already looted the guardhouse. It ain't that great. Sorry. Unless there's something in there you want. Okay, so yeah. You can see he can attack from the back row in, like, indoors. Like, I actually might be able to show you guys. Like, you can see everybody's weapons are lit up, but if we come in here. Okay. Now, let's see, if I move Chunkin back, you can see he can't attack because his weapon is not long range. It doesn't have reach. Baldassar actually might be able to, I don't know, for whatever reason, I had it in my head that he had a two-handed sword, and he does not, just a long sword, which I am going to take, because it is a better weapon than a battle axe, purely for the damage boost against large creatures. You can two-weapon fight in this if you want. In Baldassar's case, probably not the best idea. He is only level 4. However, Chunk, I think Chunk can probably get away with it purely because his incredible strength score is going to kind of make up a little bit for him being kind of bad. Let's see. Where did that spear go? I want this. Because I think you can probably fight with a spear from the back row. But you can see, robe can still swing, quarterstaff, bonking things from the distance. All right, now let us... Man, this is like... This is super, super touchy. I just want to see, like, what other loot we have laying around town. So there's a pile of stuff to the south. I think that might be... That's buckets, because that's the storehouse. But there's, like, stuff over here. I would like to check that out. God, I love the map in this game. It is so good. Except when it's not. But that's a ways away. Right, what is this? A dagger. Rove, can you, like... Do you detect magic by any chance? No. Damn it. I don't imagine any of the stuff that we have is magical right now. But you never know. Oh, scroll case. Hell yeah. Oh, we don't really have any scrolls, but... No, take the scroll case. There we go. That will save us some inventory space. We will have, like, bags and stuff. Bags of holding and all that. Traditional RPG. Good shit. Alright, so I think this was the inn down here. We'll go in and see what they're about. Okay, but first, can I nap now? Yes, okay. Hey, buddy. Ah, as Baldassar said, a terrible night. We've only returned to see what gift you wish to bestow. After all, a friend's gift can have a magic all its own.
One endowed with a magic which may aid in your protection. When I saw it on my travels earlier this year, I thought to buy it at a great price and sell it for one greater still. But after all you have done for us, I hope only that it keeps you safe.
We'll not forget this act of generosity. When next we return, the celebration must take a different course. Then you must watch as we buy food and drink enough for 100 revelers and 2 nights of unending song. Goodbye, until we meet again.
All right, so this helmet. This is a good helmet. Like, you can see AC bonus 2. Very, very good. What they don't tell you about this helmet is that it's got an enchantment on it that has an effect later in the game. I think I'm gonna hold on to it just for the AC. We might eventually ditch it, but we'll see. Is this? Oh, settings. It's like, I don't remember that interface button. And these are, the quick saving, quick load buttons, by the way. I am, however, I think, going to just go ahead and save here and call it an episode. So, as per usual, folks, thank you for watching. I will see you next time when we get outside of the city gates and beat the shit out of some gnolls and bugbears, if I recall correctly. Until then!
Hey, you made it to the end. Nice. If you had a good time, check out one of these other series, see if you like them. Drop a like, comment, or subscribe if you'd like to support the channel, via the machine and all that. As always, thanks for watching!